Till that time, I'm going for recording. Look at on the screen. The equation is y equal to x cube plus 3, for which you have to sketch the graph. And the interval has also been mentioned that you will take the x values from minus 3 to plus 3. And before proceeding on the namaz prayer break, I told you how to complete this table. Once you have completed this table, then you have to draw the points. Points are there in the form of ordered pair. This is first place x value and this is the y value. Together they will give you one point on the xy plane. So at minus 3, look here. And in the morning I also told you that draw neat and clean graph. And first you draw the x-axis, then y-axis, mention x dash, O is the origin, you should also mention then y dash. And my 5 units I'm taking on the x-axis and 1 unit equal to 1 in along the y-axis. So minus 3, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, and minus 24 will come downwards. This is 10, this is 20, and these are the 4 points. So minus 24 is this point. Minus 3, minus 24, where the two horizontal and vertical line cross each other. On the graph paper, the good thing is that you are given a network of thin lines of horizontal and vertical lines. Incoherent network of that. So you can easily locate your point. So I have counted minus 3 on the left side of the x-axis, and because y value is also negative, so I have to go downwards. So minus 24 I counted downwards. So this, where the two lines cross each other, this is your required point. Next point is minus 2, minus 5 is minus 2, and go 5 units along the negative y-axis. Similarly, minus 1, 2 a plus hai, so you have to go up. At 0, it is 3 further up on the y-axis. And then 1, 4, at 1, you will be counting 4 units along the y-axis. Then at 2, it's 11, at 2, you will go upwards 11 units. And at 3, it's 30, it will go much above, I mean, this is 10, then this thick line will be 20, again will be 30. Well, due to the limitation of the page and the graph, I'm taking somewhere on the plane place. But after plotting all these points, see how the curve should move. You are to join these points with a smooth line, because this is not a straight line graph. So do not use the scale. I tell you, you will be getting straight lines only when the equations are linear. But in case the equations are quadratic, then you will be getting parabola type of figures. And if the equations are cubic, you will be getting this type of shape. One arm downwards and one arm upwards of a parabola, you just assume. If this arm, I should bring it downwards again, so this whole arm will become a parabola, okay? But the right side, I have tilted to the upside. So this is the graph of x cube, cubic function. So join all these points in a smooth way, and this is the graph, and you must mention the equation of this curve. That is y equal to x cube plus 3. I hope this is clear. If there is any ambiguity, so after my lecture is over, you can ask as many questions as you want. Next example is for the reciprocal functions. See, draw the graph of the reciprocal function y equal to 6 upon x, and the interval is minus 5 to plus 5, except for x equal to 0. Why he is asking you, do not put x as 0. If assume you put x as 0, so 6 divided by 0 will jump to infinity. Remember, gentlemen, anything divided by 0 is always infinity. And infinity, you can't have a point on the graph paper. So that is useless. That's why we do not put x as 0. So in this interval from minus 5 to plus 5, first we make a table of values for all the negative values. And the same value will come for the positive values. Look here. First we make the table of values for the positive x. I mean, just immediate ahead 0. Immediate ahead 0 means I am taking a point as 0.5. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay? Kyunki hum dekhte hain close to 0, what is the behavior of the graph? Close to 0 is 0.5. If I put 0.5 here in this function, x has 0.5. 0.5 means 1 by 2. So 2 will be then coming in the numerator. So the answer will become 12. Or you can use your calculator, just put x as 0.5 and then solve it. You will see the value of y comes to be 12. The moment you are going to put the next point, 1, 6 divided by 1, the value of y will be 1. Then put x as 2, now 2 rakhoge, 6 divided by 2 will be 3. Then put x as 3, 6 divided by 3, answer will be 2. Put x as 4, the 6 by 4 will be 1.5. Put x as 5, 6 divided by 5 will be 1 by 2. At times you may be facing some decimal values, no problem. And the moment we are going to put the same values in negative, you see, my left hand side interval is having the same values but negative values. Negative values, okay. So, aap jaise negative value yahan rakhoge x ki, to y will also be negative. So, same values, same answers, but now with negative values. At again 0.5, it will be minus 12. At minus 5, minus 1 to minus 6, minus 2 to minus 3. So just keep on changing the signs. You'll be getting the negative side of this curve. Ab hum pehle right side plot kar lete hain. Right side hamari ye hogi positive values ke saath, aur left side aayegi negative values ke saath. This curve is very important, gentlemen. This is a reciprocal graph. Instead of 6 by x, we may give you 1 by x. So nevertheless, we'll be getting a curve of the same shape. Okay, look here. At 0.5, I'm taking 2 units, you see, either here. 4 small square as 1 unit. Okay. 5 nahi liya maine, 4 pe 1 unit, 8 pe 2 units, 12 pe 3 units, 16 pe 4 units or 20 by 5 units. मेरे पास 20 points हैं, इसलिए मैंने 4 units का scale ले लिया. Same you will take on the negative x-axis. And taking one small square as 1 along the y-axis, तो वो y पे 1 equal to 1 ही चलेगा. Okay, when x is 0.5, 0.5 means half, ये 1 से आधा यहाँ पे आ जाएगा, 2 units पे ये हो जाएगा 0.5. X is 0.5, and you go 12 units. So this is 10. This is no 12. Then here will come. Draw this point here. This will be 12 units. Okay. Plot this point over here. Next is minus 1. Sorry, 1 to 6. This is 0.1 and goes 6, 5 units, and this is correct 1 and comma 6. Next is 2, 3. At 2, just count 3 units above, because this, both the values are positive. At 3, the value is 2. So at this is the 3. You must mark it first, and then 2 units above. At 4, it is 1.5. At 5, it is 1.2. It's close to 1. And then with the very smooth line, you just join all these points. ये फर्स्ट हाफ हो गया हमारा 6yx का, एंड सी फॉर द नेगेटिव हाफ एट माइनस 0.5, ये होगा माइनस 0.5, हाफ आधा होगा ना, तो आंसर इज माइनस 12, तो ये यहाँ पे आ जाएगा आपका माइनस 12 समवेयर, देन यहाँ हो गया मोटी लाइन पर और माइनस 12, ओके, इसको यहाँ पे शॉर्ट कर लीजिएगा. सिमिलरली एट माइनस 1 इट इज माइनस 6, दिस माइनस 1 एंड दिस पॉइंट इज माइनस 6. At minus 2, it is minus 3. देखें, 3 units I'm going down. At minus 3, go down to 2 units. At minus 4, 1.5 units. At minus 5, it's very close to minus 1. Then after plotting these points, then join all with a smooth curve. So half of the curve will be here and half of the curve will be here. देखें, at x equal to 0, the function is jumping to either plus infinity or jumping to minus infinity. नीचे जा रहा है ना? The curve is not defined x at x equal to 0. Okay? For all reciprocal functions like y equal to 6 over x, the moment x is coming in the denominator, there will be a jump to infinity and you have to avoid that point. And the function close to that point will be taking very fastly and abruptly really reaching up to plus infinity and minus infinity. I hope this curve is also clear. My next reciprocal function is a upon x square. In the previous case, it was simply x, now a upon x square. Draw the graph of 1 upon x square in the interval minus 4 to plus 4. Dekhiye isko. So once the interval is given, so these are the x values which are given to you. Fine. From minus 4 to plus 4. But again, at 0, it will not be defined. I told you 1 upon 0 will jump to infinity. So you just leave 0 and close to 0, take half on the right side and minus half on the left side. Half and minus half means 0.5 on the right side and minus 0.5 on the left. So include these two points instead of zero. अब देखिए यहाँ पे 1 upon x square करना है, तो minus 4 का square लोगे तो 1 upon 16 हो जाएगा. अच्छा, इसमें पहले x square लिया है, सबका squared values कर दो. इन्हीं का square, ये x का column है, just he is squaring all the x columns. Minus 3 का square 9, minus 2 का 4, minus 1 का 1, minus 0.5 will become after square plus का 0.25. 5 plus 0.25, 1, 4, 9, and 16. And then take its reciprocal. Reciprocal means just take 1 upon 16. So 1 upon 16 is coming to be 0.06. 1 upon 9 is coming to be 0.11. 1 upon 4 will be 0.25. 1 upon 1 will remain 1. And in that way, you will be getting all these values. Okay. Now you'll be making the pair with the first row with the last row. Okay, yeah, no? 1 upon x square. So my x coordinate is minus 4 and my y coordinate is 0.06. Look here. X coordinate is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. And this is 0.06. Yani ek hisse ka bhi chhata hissa karna hai. Ek jo difference hai. So this will be very close to the x axis. My next point is minus 3 and minus 0.1. So this is minus 3 and minus 0.1. तकरीबन 10th पार्ट है इसका. At minus 2 it is 0.25. At minus 2 it is 0.25. तो ये 1 है ना, यहाँ पे भी हमने 1, 2, 3 इसी तरह रखा है. 5 units को 1 लिया है. Both 5 small scales equal to 1. At minus 1 it is 1. तो ये minus 1 है और ये plus 1 है. Okay, this point. At minus 0.5, this is your minus 0.5. The answer is coming to be 4. Yeah, 4. Similarly, at 0.5, iska mid mein aayega, aur answer is again coming to be 4. At 1, it is 1. It is 1, this is 1. At 2, this is a point, 0.25. At 3, coming closer to the x-axis. So, in points, join with the smooth curve. इसको भी ज्वाइन कीजिए। अब वो जो हिस्सा आपका यहाँ पे आ रहा था, नाउ इट्स गोइंग लाइक दिस, बट दिस इज द ग्राफ ऑफ y इक्वल टू वन अपॉन एक्स के। माय नेक्स्ट ग्राफ इज द एक्सपोनेंशियल फंक्शन। सी द जनरल फॉर्म ऑफ द एक्सपोनेंशियल फंक्शन इज y इक्वल टू a पावर x। रिमेंबर a इज ए कॉन्स्टेंट, x इज अ वेरिएबल। आप x स्क्वायर पढ़ते हैं ना, पढ़ा है ना x स्क्वायर, तो दैट इज कॉल्ड द अलजेब्रिक फंक्शन। व्हेन बेस इज द वेरिएबल एंड पावर इज अ कॉन्स्टेंट। बट इफ द सिचुएशन इज अदरवाइज, टू नीचे आ जाए एज अ बेस और बेस x जो है वो पावर बन जाए, देन इन दैट केस वी कॉल इट द एक्सपोनेंशियल फंक्शन। एक बड़ा मशहूर एक्सपोनेंशियल फंक्शन e पावर x, e is also a constant, its value is 2.718, you can see from your calculators. So there's a particular case of exponential function, maybe 3 power x, maybe 3 power minus x, maybe 4 power 2x minus 1. These are all the exponential functions where the base is a constant and power is a variable. Now the most simple function we I'm taking here as an example, y equal to 2 power x, and in the interval minus 1 to x is 2.5. Because the interval is very short, so I'll be taking the difference of 0.5 each. So start from minus 1, then minus 0.5, then 0, then 0.5, aadhe aadhe ka farak lete jaiye, then 1, 1.5, then 2, then 2.5. So in that way, you'll be getting some values in your table. Keep on putting these values of x, because interval is there. Put these values of x here in the equation. So 2 power minus 1, you know, power x is minus 1, 2 power minus 1. So you will calculate, this will become 1 over 2 and 1 over t is 0.5. And you can see it from your calculators. Next value is 2 power minus 0.5. 2 power minus 0.5. You'll see it from your calculator, 0.7. 2 power 0, you know very well, anything power 0 is always 1. So 2 power 0 will be 1. 2 power 0.5, it will become 1.4. 1 the core that will remain 2, the y will remain 2 when x is 1. When x is 1.5, it becomes 2.8. When it's 2, 2 plus square 2, 4 ho jayega. And if the power is 2.5, answer is coming to be 5.7. So plot all these ordered pairs. And scale is same, 1 unit, 10 small squares, 1 unit on the x-axis as well on the y-axis. 10 small square ye hota hai, ek jo bada dabba hota na, big square. This is 10 small square, okay. You count it as 1 unit, then 2 unit, 3 unit aage ja raha hai, lekin 2.5 unit, kyunki aakhri aapki value 2.5. So mark it 2.5. The least value is minus 1, so mark minus 1 also. 0.5 you need, so minus 0.5 aapko chahiye. Plus 0.5 yahan par likh sakte hain, it's better to write. Okay, then locate the points. At minus 1, this is 0.5. So this is minus 1. And go upwards 0.5. Kyunki ye ek to ye banega na, one ye banega. So this is 0.5. At minus 0.5 here, minus 0.5, the value is 0.7. So 7 small scales count ke liye 0.7 ho jayega. At 0 it is 1, 0 hai ye origin hai, it is 1. Okay, 0, 1. Then 0.5, this value is 0.5. You have to go up 1.4. 1 ye ho gaya, 4 units further. So this is 1.4. The point will be 0.5, 1.4. 1, 2, this is 1, and 2 units you go up, this is 1, 2. So similarly, you can plot all the remaining points and join with very smooth curve with a freehand sketch. Keep on turning the curve smoothly. The line should not be thick, moti line nahi banani aapko. Small, lean, lean and thin, thin line, sharp line, nazar aana chahiye. And the last point also considered, that is 2.5 and 5.9. This is the last point. And mention your equation y is equal to 2 power x. This is the graph of the exponential function. And gentlemen, remember, every graph of exponential function will never go below the x-axis. It will not cross the x-axis. It will not go below the x-axis. ये देख रहे हैं आप, पूरा कर्व हमारा x-axis के ऊपर ऊपर है. हर एक्सपोनेंशियल फंक्शन इसी तरह होगा. It will never go below the x-axis. Let's see. Okay, then I have given you a list of problems. ये मैंने मुख्तलिफ बुक से आपके लिए क्वेश्चंस सिलेक्ट किए हैं. In some cases I have mentioned the intervals. In some cases I haven't. जहां पे मैंने आपको इंटरवल नहीं दिया तो यू कैन चूज एक्स वैल्यूज फ्रॉम योर ओन साइड. यहाँ पे आप एक्स को 1 रख लें, 2 रख लें, 3 रख लें, 7 रख लें, 10 रख लें. चॉइस इज योर्स. सो क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 पर्टेन्स टू द ग्राफ ऑफ द लीनियर इक्वेशंस एंड इन ईच केस यू विल बी गेटिंग अ स्ट्रेट लाइन. क्वेश्चन 2, ऑल द पार्ट्स यू लुक दे आर द क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशंस, इंटरवल्स आर मेंशन एंड दे विल बी रिप्रेजेंटिंग पैराबोलास. ओके, क्वेश्चन नंबर 3, देयर आर टू पार्ट्स, द मैक्सिमम पावर ऑफ द वेरिएबल इज 3, वी कॉल इट द क्यूबिक इक्वेशन, इंटरवल्स आर आल्सो देयर, मेक टेबल ऑफ वैल्यूज एंड ड्रॉ एंड आई हैव गिवन एग्जांपल हाउ व्हाट विल बी द शेप ऑफ द क्यूबिक इक्वेशन. द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज द रेसिप्रोकल फंक्शंस, इंटरवल्स आर आल्सो मेंशनड. इन रेसिप्रोकल फंक्शंस को आप देखिएगा इसकी शेप कैसे आ रही है एंड plot them in these intervals. And the next is solve the following simultaneous equations using the graph method. आपको पेपर में मैं कैसा क्वेश्चन बनाऊंगा? I'll say that solve this system of equations by elimination method number 1 and by graphical method. ये graphical method this is I have just taught you. So keep in mind, if a question comes in your paper like that, that same question you are to do graphically and you are to do by either the elimination method or by the substitution method. So how do we solve a system of linear equations? The three methods you must know, and the remaining methods I'll teach you in the forthcoming lectures. And the last question is draw the graph of the following exponential functions. So these are all three parts I have given. Everyone is an exponential function. You can take interval from your own side for x values and then draw the graph, and you will see that every graph is going up the x-axis. And now I'll ask you टू ड्रॉ, कोई एक सा ग्राफ ड्रॉ कीजिए. चलिए ये क्वेश्चन करें, क्वेश्चन 2 का थर्ड पार्ट. जेंटलमैन, दिस इज क्वेश्चन 2 एंड दिस इज थर्ड पार्ट. वाई इक्वल टू एक्स स्क्वायर माइनस 4x प्लस 3 and the interval is from minus 4 to plus 4. So keep going with me. Well, my lecture is almost complete. Jo aapko diya aapko, ab thodi some practice karenge. So for that matter, I am going to stop my recording.